everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to run through the termination of noradrenaline. As you would have learned in my last video, noradrenaline is a neurotransmitter also known as norepinephrine. Two main ways the noradrenaline response is terminated is via reuptake and degradation. Let's start off with reuptake. Extracellular noradrenaline is transported back into the presynaptic terminal by a high-affinity transporter protein called the noradrenaline transporter. Once noradrenaline is in the intracellular space, it is repackaged into vesicles by VMAT2, short for vesicular monoamine transporter. It's then stored in these vesicles until the neurotransmitter is required again. Let's move on to degradation. This is when the neurotransmitter is broken down into metabolites. An enzyme called monoamine oxygenase A metabolizes noradrenaline. This degradation process can take place intracellularly and extracellularly. Another enzyme that metabolizes noradrenaline is catechol-O-methyltransferase. This is a membrane-bound protein found on the postsynaptic terminal within the central nervous system. We should note the degradation process contains more steps, but it leads to a final metabolite called VMA. Short for vanillyl mandelic acid, which is a metabolite excreted in the urine. Here, I just wanted to quickly explain the effects of cocaine. This drug inhibits the transporter, therefore there is no reuptake of noradrenaline. Cocaine inhibits noradrenaline, dopamine, and serotonin transporters. Another drug of interest is amphetamine. This drug has two mechanisms of action, whereby it reverses the transport of noradrenaline into the extracellular space and inhibits monoamine oxygenase. This last slide just sums up the whole process just described, so hit the pause and take it all in. That's all for today.